What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? So we just got our first patch notes for Remnant 2, and the changes look pretty good. I'm gonna go ahead and read through the article for you. Mostly the important stuff, just skipping some of the basic improvements to crashing and performance. As far as quality of life, we have increased trait cap by 5 so that you don't have a trait with only 5 points in it. Tomes of Knowledge now grant scrap and EXP when the player has reached a trait cap. Orb of Undoing now has unlimited uses. Players can sell any extras for scrap. Remove the trait requirement for equipping a second archetype. Players can now slot their second archetype as soon as they obtain or convert another engram at Wally. Remove the scrap cost for converting a mysterious item into an engram, and lower the Luminite cost for converting a mysterious item into an engram. Slightly increase scrap gain from breakables, rare chests, and aberrations, and reduce the cost of Bloodroot. Right off the bat, this fixes the biggest issues I had with the game, as scrap is a pain to get early on, and then the traits just felt really goofy. This made it a lot better. For the Explorer archetype, we have increased duration of the Scavenger and Gold Digger buffs from 15 seconds to 20 seconds, and the increased healing amount of Gold Digger Healing Fountain from 1.5 to 2.0 HP per second. For Archon, all of its skills got buffed, and the cooldown got decreased quite a bit. This is because there was an issue where Archon was getting basically ridiculous damage due to a bug, so now it's been overall buffed to compensate. The Challenger archetype adjusted the damage falloff for Challenger's close quarters perk. At maximum range, Challenger will always maintain a 10% damage bonus to all damage. For Handler, we have increased Handler Pack Hunter range from 25 meters to 40 meters and increased the base health of the Handler's Very Good Boy companion, because he was dying too quickly. For Summoner, we have increased the base health of Summoner's Hollow and Flyer variants, as they literally died with any AoE attack. It was a pain and really made the Summoner class useless on Apocalypse, so hopefully that fixes that for a lot of those builds. As far as weapons go, we have switched Aphelion scaling to boss special damage scaling instead of standard and increased the fire damage from Shatterstar. Of course, we have the fire rate was reduced on Nightfall in standard and Dreadwalker fire modes. Nightfall was dealing far more damage than other weapons in both modes. When considering damage and the mod ability, it was pushing Nightfall too far above every other long gun, and now sits closer in line with other high damage weapons. We also have a major nerf to Enigma. The subsequent tether damage of Enigma's primary fire was decreased, the AoE damage was decreased, magazine capacity decreased, yet the reserve capacity was increased. Enigma was performing too far above our goal for AoE clear, so a few adjustments were made. There's still an issue with ignoring armor, which will be addressed in the future. However, when that happens, we'll reevaluate the numbers. Basically, you could use this thing to clear the entire game, even on Apocalypse. Adds were nothing, so they made it do a little bit less, so it's not too OP for that. When talking about enemies, we actually have reduced damage on Nightweaver's grab attacks with the wall and lunge. I'm assuming this is the one where she grabs you and insta-kills you. Seems like that won't necessarily be an insta-kill now. Adjusted the hitbox of Magister Dulian's tongue attack to better match the visuals. That attack was really goofy, so glad they fixed that one. In multiplayer, you'll take a little bit less damage from shots by your own teammates. Now, of course, we get to the bug fixes, and all this stuff is like fixing crashes, bugs with cutscenes so that you couldn't exit the game and go back in. A lot of that stuff has been fixed, but let's skip down all the way to some more of the archetype fixes and gear fixes. Fixed an issue with Archon's Havoc form Lightning Hands. Casting speed now promptly ramps up the Lightning Hand without going infinite. Fixed an issue causing Hunter's Focus not granting the proper weak spot damage. Fixed an issue with Hunter Shroud granting multiplicative damage bonus. Fixed an issue causing Invader perk Shark to not apply its damage bonuses. Invader was basically useless, so this will hopefully fix it. Fixed an issue with Gunslinger Bulletstorm sound not terminating, and fixed a bug allowing Male Engineer to ignore falling transition when overclocking. And talking about items, we have fixed VFX alignment for Nebula and Hellfire primary fire, fixed an issue preventing Plasma Cutter from dealing the correct damage type to certain enemies. Fixed an issue causing Shield Breaker Mutator to not grant the correct amount of shield. This one sometimes just didn't work at all. Nightfall mod visual effects terminate correctly now. Fixed an issue allowing Dreamcatcher to trigger Dream Wave before it was promptly earned. Fixed an issue that allowed Crystal Heart from stacking with itself. Also fixed an issue with the Ring of Flawless Beauty not granting the proper weak spot damage. Fixed an issue with one of the rings causing infinite damage stacking on summons. Fixed an issue preventing some boss and special melee weapons from receiving proper scaling, and fixed an issue preventing God Splitter from triggering Was This Supposed to Happen achievement. There were a couple fixes to some of the enemies as well, but one I wanted to point out was the fixed issue with Nightweaver projectiles homing in on player incorrectly. This one actually was pretty annoying in the Nightweaver fight on harder difficulties, as occasionally the projectiles would literally turn all the way around and hit you. It was a pain. So now those are properly going to home in and not just be cheats. Lastly, we have some miscellaneous fixes. Fixed multiple locations on final level where player could get out of bounds of the level. Fixed an issue with players not receiving fall damage by holding throwable consumables or melee weapons in throwing position. Fixed collision issue causing players to get trapped along some edges in Morrow Sanatorium. Fixed issue with using certain melee weapons, the character's face distorted. Fixed issue where player could be locked out of Postulate's Parlor when application was closed after playing the board game. Fixed an issue where player was unable to open the door Sentinel's keep when exiting game while inputting the Seeker's key last acquired in Nerud. Fixed an issue where players were trapped when attempting to vault through a wall in Cotton's Kiln. Fixed an issue that allowed players to skip siege fight in Tiller's Rest. Fixed an issue with players falling into gaps between boats and walls in Tiller's Rest. Fixed floating doors in Cathedral of Omens. Fixed an issue in the Great Hall that allowed repeated AEXP rewards during Feastmaster's event. Fixed multiple scenarios that allow players to transition through walls using interactives. Essentially, you could use this to give your friend a high five and push them through a door that you hadn't opened, and so now you could cheat and get all the loot. Fixed an issue that caused players to get stuck in throw animation in certain situations and adjusted the kill volume height in the Custodian Eye Arena. Now, this is a pretty quick patch from the devs here. This came out not too long after the game, and most of it fixes the biggest issues with the game. Nightfall being way too overpowered, Enigma being way too overpowered, some of the boss fights being a little too bogus with the Nightweaver insta-grabbing you and killing you, stuff like that. Trait caps, scrap drops, all this should improve the quality of the game and make it much more playable. The game's already pretty great, but there are some issues, and I think all of this really rounded it out. Let's see where we go with the next patch, but for now, looking good. Thanks for watching, everybody, and I'll catch you next time.